So today we are going to be reading the Bible, specifically Ephesians 6. So Ephesians 6 is the armor of God. So recently I've just written, you know, having this video idea in the back of my head, because every day I wake up and I do like my quiet time. So I read a chapter in the Bible and then I do like my devotion and then I pray. And every day when I pray the armor of God over my body. And this is such an important thing to do every single day. And I think a lot of people disregard this as something to do every single day. I think this gets passed over and looked over. I really want to tell you guys how important this is and how this will protect you from everything. God gives us armor to put on. He gives it freely to us to put on every single day so that we will be protected from everything that Satan wants to put out in this world and wants to harm us with. So to not put on this armor every day and to not use that to our advantage is kind of silly, because he gives it to us freely and all we have to do is pray and ask him for it every single day, and he gives it to us. Especially in this time that we're living in right now, it is so important to protect yourself. And I think a lot of the times we think that just prayer and praying to God will protect us. And of course, like, if you pray to God, he will hear you and he will answer your prayers. But he has already given us the tools. He's already given us the tool belt to use to guard against us, and so that we can have this armor. So it's kind of silly for us to be praying and asking him to protect us when he's already given us the tools to use to protect us from things. I'm going to go over each of the articles of clothing that you put on to protect yourself, and I'm going to explain each one and what each one means and what each one protects you from. And then also at the end, I'm going to show you guys this prayer that actually my grandma gave me during like quarantine, when everything was really starting to ramp up. And this is a prayer to wear the armor of God, and this is kind of like an outline that you can use, and this will help you to pray the armor of God over you every single day. The whole armor of God is in Ephesians 6, and it's Ephesians 6, 10 through 20. So this is the Bible that I'll be reading out of. This is my little travel Bible. This has been through a lot. I've put this in my backpack. It's gone a lot of places with me. It's gotten spilled on. I think I said this in my last ASMR video, but yeah, this Bible is super special. My mom actually gave it to me, and it has my name on it, Lily. And then it says, "For I can do everything through Christ who gives me strength," which is Philippians 4:13. Scripture verses for different things that I would So like alcohol and drugs, I have scriptures for that. And then I had, well, this is only one of the two pages. I don't know where the other page went. I lost it. But I have like, no one is perfect. Like judgment, love, insecurity, loneliness, all that kind of stuff. And then I have these random notes. This is actually from a conference that I went to. All right, so that is that. Let me flip to Ephesians 6, 11.
Satan's lying
what is false. And so that is super important. The belt of truth is so important, and it sets us free. It sets us free from the lies of the enemy. It sets us free from the lies of the world. It sets us free from the lies of our peers. And we will immediately know that is not true because we have the Spirit in us. We pray the belt of truth over us, that we will have truth in every circumstance. And then I pray the breastplate of righteousness. So this one was a little tricky. I didn't always understand what the breastplate of righteousness meant. The breastplate of righteousness protects my heart. The heart is the most vulnerable place in your body, because where Satan can creep into your heart, he can creep in and destroy everything. If you let Satan creep into your heart, you can go back down the path that you were before you were saved. You could fall backwards, because Satan is not clever. He's not creative. So he will just use the same tactics. So praying the breastplate of righteousness over your heart, well, I always pray to guard my heart and to put a wall of protection around my heart that Satan cannot get into it, no matter what the day holds, no matter what the day brings, that my heart will not be pulled toward the wrong direction. Also, that my heart will be loving towards others. I would have compassion and love and self-control and patience for others, because my heart is protected from Satan and those evil thoughts, like being mean to someone, or being impatient with someone, or being smart or snappy with someone, will not be able to be allowed, because I have the breastplate of righteousness protecting my heart, because those are things of Satan, not things of God. And then next, I pray the shield of faith, which is really like the shield and the sword of the Spirit are like super like keys. You need those two in your day-to-day life. It literally says that the shield will deflect the fiery arrows that come at you. It will stop the fiery arrows of the devil. This is so important. Don't you want a shield that will protect you and will literally stop Satan in his footsteps, because you have that shield around you? So what I pray, you know, when you think of a shield, you think of like Captain America, his like shield that only he can hold. But I just pray and imagine a shield of protection around my whole body, like a whole bubble of protection. And so I just pray for the shield of faith that will protect me and deflect the fiery arrows that come at me, and that I will not be attacked by Satan's schemes or tactics or anything, because I have the shield of faith. And I know in my heart that if I prayed the shield of faith over my body, that I will not be hurt. I will not be taken advantage of by the devil. So the shield of faith is super important, but the sword of the Spirit is my favorite, because I literally have a sword. No, you can't see it. None of this is visible, but praying for the sword of the Spirit is basically praying for the most powerful weapon. And I mean, I've seen it in my life that I've prayed the sword of the Spirit and I've been protected from so many things, and I've been able to fight in battles that I never thought I would have been able to win, or I would have been able to conquer or overcome. So the sword of the Spirit is actually the word of God. So it is the Bible. So when I'm praying for the sword of the Spirit, I'm praying that God would help me to use the word to fight. And it says that the word of God is sharper than any two-edged sword. It's sharper than any weapon. It's more harmful than any gun. And so I pray that God would help me to use the word, would help me to bring the word up in situations where I'm feeling attacked or I'm feeling like I'm going to be defeated. The word is sharper than any two-edged sword, and I pray that I'd be able to use it, and God would show me how to use it in situations. It pierces through flesh and bone, and I just thank God every day for the sword of the Spirit, which is the word. And then lastly, I pray for the helmet of salvation. I've kind of made up my own prayer for the helmet of salvation, because it says it's the salvation that you wear, because then when you put on your helmet, people will know that you're saved. But what I've been praying is that I put on my helmet of salvation to remind myself every day that I'm a child of God, that I'm born again, that I'm saved, that I have my head protected, my mind protected. Your mind is one of the most important things, your mind and your heart. So I pray that my mind would be protected. Satan's schemes that when I put on the helmet, I remind myself daily that I'm born again, I'm a child of God, that my mind's protected. I like the things in my mind that I think of, like, I will never be good enough for anything. My dreams will never come true. I will go down in a dark hole again. I will not have any friends anymore. All of those are lies from the enemy. And when I put on my helmet, I will not believe those lies. Those lies are not even able to come into my mind because I prayed for the helmet of salvation. But also, when I put on the helmet of salvation, I ask God that that people would see my helmet and want one for themselves, and so then I would be able to take my helmet and put it on others so that we would all be able to have helmets of salvation and just save people wherever I go, whether it be on my YouTube channel, whether it be at work, whether it be at a school, whether it be at a grocery store. I just pray that I would be able to give the helmet of salvation, show the helmet of salvation to people all around the world. And yeah, that is the armor of God. It also says to pray in the spirit at all times, on every occasion, to stay alert. So that is why I pray every single day. It is such a tremendous help. I think it's silly not to, because God's literally given us this gift of this armor to use every single day, and it's silly not to. I'm going to now go ahead and pray this prayer. It is really amazing, and I hope that you guys pray this prayer as well. Heavenly Father, I put on the armor of God with gratitude and praise. You have provided all I need to stand in victory against Satan and his kingdom. I confidently take the belt of truth. Thank you that Satan cannot stand against the bold use of truth. Thank you for the breastplate of righteousness. I embrace that righteousness which is mine by faith in Jesus Christ. I know that Satan must retreat before the righteousness of God. You have provided the solid rock of peace. I claim the peace with God that is mine through justification. I desire the peace of God that touches my emotions and feelings through prayer and sanctification. Eagerly, Lord, I lift up the shield of faith against all the blazing missiles that Satan fires at me. I know that you are my shield. I recognize that my mind is a particular target of Satan's deceiving ways. I cover my mind with the powerful helmet of salvation. With joy, I lift the sword of the Spirit, which is the word of God. I choose to live in its truth and power. Enable me to use your word to defend myself from Satan, and also to wield the sword well, to push Satan back, to defeat him. Thank you, dear Lord, for prayer. Help me keep this armor well oiled with prayer. All these petitions I offer you through the mighty name of our Lord Jesus Christ. Amen. All right, I hope you guys enjoyed this video. I hope you understand the armor of God more now than you did before. And I just hope that you would pray the armor of God over your bodies every single day to protect you and to help you fight, especially in this time of confusion and of need. And I love you guys so much. Thank you for watching. Make sure to go follow me on my Instagram if you have not already. It is lily_bear with 3 R's. And make sure to subscribe as well. There's going to be so many more awesome videos coming up. I would not want you guys to miss them. And yeah, I will see you guys in my next video.